Down to Milford Sound from here, and we drop another 3 to the mountain on the other side. Now this is the Clearedow River that we're crossing right here, and this is the first of many times that we'll cross the Clearedow as we go down the through the canyon. As you can see, there's not much rain even here yet because that river is still dry back there, so it can rain a lot up. Now, there is a shortcut here, but I think we've got enough time to get down around the long way today. It blows in here against these mountain sides. The clouds are built up on this side of the mountain. They build up to such an extent throughout the morning. And then when we get down the Hollyford Valley again this afternoon, it'll be another...
Daddy, what?
Now, as I said earlier also, it's not told to get 300 inches a year in here. Well, one day last year, they measured the rain. It gets its name from a man by the name of John Grodo. He came from Milford Haven in Wales. And that's how Milford Sound actually gets its name. And he also named this the Clearedow Canyon after the heifer. It'll take you 10 minutes to walk in.
Thank you. the way the water came off the mountain.
Thank you.
go down to the second mark, a fair way down the road there. And all the was all the concrete right down to there. Why it was concrete was to safeguard the miners when they were working in the tunnel. Well, on the second year of construction, in the actual tunnel,
then what they do is they lift the baskets out of the water and they just place the baskets in the back of the tunnel.
They walk through Cook Strait, up the east coast of the North Island, over the top of Cape Reinga, back down the west coast of the North Island, back through Cook Strait, down the east coast and back to Fiordland. Now, if crayfish will live up to 40 to 50 years, when the fishermen know that the fish are walking, they become docile. So they invented what is known as the gun that threw the net. They had it mounted on each skid of the helicopter, and they also had a gun that